Sustainable energy should be a really important part of our conversation about capital improvement. For obvious reasons, you know, Fairfax County has already done a really good job of becoming efficient. The facility staff has focused on that. We actually have the most ENERGY STAR rated school buildings in the country, just as an absolute number, even more than Los Angeles, which has more schools than we do. So we're doing a great job on becoming efficient and saving money that way and saving energy that way. But that's obviously not enough. We need to turn the corner to renewables. And right now in our capital improvement program, which goes out a couple of decades, we don't have a single project in the pipeline that is to any degree off the grid. And that's not acceptable to me. We need to do that, not only for the reasons of, you know, the sustainability of our budget, right? But also obviously because at some point the market is going to turn the corner. There will be a tipping point, and we have to be poised to take advantage of that, you know, where renewables will actually be, even in terms of your initial investment, renewables will be more efficient than fossil fuels. So I think we could be doing more. I know that the school system staff, they are working with the vendors in the renewables industry, but they, you know, I think it also helps to have a push from the school board. And so the board is beginning to do that, working with the superintendent. And we have asked the superintendent to come back to the board in the fall with a plan, you know, go through the CIP, you know, tell us what's out there, what's on the horizon, how are those conversations going with the vendors, what's possible, what are other school systems doing, because we are behind. And so that hopefully that conversation will be in time for us to get something actually concrete in the capital improvement program. So why is that important? Obviously, it's important for our bottom line, you know, but it's also, I don't know, all the things we talk about that worry us in terms of, you know, educating kids. If we're not giving them a sustainable, livable planet to grow up into, it's almost like we might as well not have the other conversations. It's the one thing that we're running out of time on. And with our footprint and our opportunity, our physical footprint and our opportunity, we should be leading on this for the sake of the kids. There's also, you know, the green schools is also about using that as learning opportunities and project opportunities for kids. And I have visited schools in other counties where it's all seamlessly connected, and it's an opportunity not only to get your building off the grid, but also get the kids learning hands-on about what the future, because this is the future that they are going to be having to move into and create.